No, Aaron is. He just blew me away. He was so perfect for it. We then looked what he looked like with blonde hair. I was suddenly thinking we're going to do a Colin Farrell and Alexander the Great. I was like, I just thought, look, he's so good, and he so became the character as an actor. And I rang up. I sent photographs to Mark and showed him the casting and the tapes, and he was just like, that's our kid. Just cast him. So I was like, look, if I feel it and the creator feels it, then we've got to go for it.
What's the essence of that character for you?
Everyday kid. He's Peter Parker. But he's in high school, and he doesn't get bitten by a spider. He just loves Spider-Man and tries to become a superhero. And he does something that I think a lot of us should do. He doesn't cross the street and he sees someone in trouble. He goes and helps. And that's actually one of the main themes of this film. You know, when people, you know, the Daily Mail can jump up and down, focusing on, oh, look at the guns and knives and swearing. But maybe they should also look. And actually, you know, this is about us saying to people, this is in the society we live in, you know, people don't help each other anymore. You know, there was a time, you know, I'm sure when our parents, and, you know, were a lot, you know, in the 60s, or grandparents, if you saw someone being mugged, you'd walk over and say, what are you doing? Or help. Or if someone got hit by, you know, it's, and I do think that blind eye syndrome is pretty bad in England right now.
Nick Cage.
The wonderful Nick.
Yeah. What was the reason behind casting him? Because there's
his love of comics.
Yeah.
I knew when we'd finished it, I sent it straight off to his agent saying, you've got to give this to Nick. You will not understand a word of it, but give it to Nick. And his agent was like, yeah, you're right, I've read it, I don't get it, but I will give it to Nick. And then the agent rang me up like 24 hours later saying, thank you for telling me to give it to Nick, because he's jumped up and down with excitement. And then Nick called me, and he got every single, I mean, he knows more about comic books than I do. I mean, every reference he got. And then when he came in and we did the first rehearsals, he was just mind-blowing. I mean, you see, he made a decision where I was looking at him in the rehearsals going, hey, Nick, are you doing what I think you're doing? He's like, yeah, what do you think? And I was like, brave, a lot of people won't get it, but the people who do will think it's a stroke of genius.
Is this a sort of wait until you see the film kind of thing, or can you tell us more?
Wait till you see the film. He's doing a, you know, for me, he's doing a performance which is sort of Raising Arizona meets Wild at Heart.
Sounds cool. So yeah. The old out there Nick Cage will be known and loved.
He's out there.
Oh, and one last word about Chris, if you will.
Yeah.
You said yourself, I mean, yeah, a lot of people will see him as McLovin. You think this is a role that will maybe break those conceptions?
Do you know what? He really is a very, very good actor. When his agent rang up, saying, oh, you should, you know, meet Chris, and, you know, and I met him, when I first met Chris, I was having breakfast in LA with a very famous actor, and Chris was early, which was a good sign, rare for an actor, so, and he came bounding over the table, and the very famous actor, I thought, oh, here we go, Chris will be all over this guy, and I'll have to introduce him, it'll be embarrassing. And then an extremely famous actor just turned around and went, oh, it's you! You are brilliant! And stuff. And then Chris was like, yeah, I like your work as well, man. and I think he was... I had lunch yesterday, and we were actually with the producer of Fast Times at Ridgemont High. Mm-hmm. And he said, and he was right, he said, you've done what Sean Penn did. You're a great actor, but you started off with a, you know, the character from Fast Times at Ridgemont. You've done something which you'll be known for a long time, but you will then, you just got to do a few more roles, and that will be, it's like his launching pad.
Oh, wow, yeah.
You know, and
he's natural, yeah.
He's a phenomenally gifted actor.
Yeah.
Phenomenally, he's great.
And Red Mist, to me, because it's quite a complex character in a way.
Well, he plays it, that's what I'm saying, he's doing it all. He's not, you know, he's not just being the funny, nerdy kid in this at all. Hmm. He's got every, he really goes up and down, and he's holding his own against Mark, which is quite a feat.